that this member life is long. Last week we talked about remember the mirror. We also said we asked the question about too close to the mirror to see what you see in there. And if we are too close, that means we need help. So I'm here to tell somebody here this morning, if you think you were to what you are, you might not think you are what you are.
Hey, come on now.
That's when you need to talk to God.
Yes, yes.
God will give you wisdom to understand what it's all about.
Yes.
But right now, speaking of the ministry, we preach, we protest, we meet, trying to find ways to combat the evil in this world. Forgiving, though, that goes for Jesus has already told us to do. I read where I say, if I lift it up, I'll draw men unto me. Somewhere in this sermon, most are not doing what the fourth man of that crew asked us to do. In fact, I find today we have two in the sheep herd, and none left shepherds. Sheep herders that drive the sheep, but the shepherds stop to take care of the sheep. You will figure that out. I pray you already have. That's what's wrong with the world again. We have a lot of sheep herders.
Right.
I call the sheep fleeces these, just for the wool. Other than that, they do not become shepherds. But we talk about the fourth member of that troop. You all probably remember Frank Bowman, one of the three astronauts to circle the moon. He said before George Session of Congress, the men on Earth that kept that wrecked our mission around the clock were as the fourth member of that crew. What Bowman was saying was that without the help from the men on Earth, the mission would have been a failure or impossible. This fourth member of the crew was therefore indispensable. We have found in our life, if you don't have that fourth member in your life,
right,
you will live in a lost life.
Praise
or you might think you're happy, but it's a joy that will not last.
Oh, hallelujah.
That this is our most dangerous concern in the world today. That too many do not know the fourth man. Those that have heard of him, somehow they say, we don't need him. Yeah, we're in trouble. But this past week, the first 7, 8, 10 days, we had people in the world more concerned about a baby born in England that will live in a palace than the one born in a stable to save life. Somebody here might know what I'm talking about. Somewhere, we have lost contact with the only Savior of the world. And that man is called Jesus. Life mission is filled with danger. On the trip to the moon, many dangers known and unknown lurk all about them. There was a change in orbit the Earth and the moon of getting in an atmosphere and getting lost. In fact, you had to deal with radiation and explosion, etc. Whenever we enter into an unknown territory, we need help. We must always remember, though, that our help comes from above. While the astronaut help was from below and above, sometime in life, also we need help from above and below. You don't live in this world by yourself.
Right.
Even so, our first cry in life is a signal that we are entering a world filled with change and danger. That's why it's always said when a newborn baby is born, that's when you should cry.
Yeah.
Knowing that they have to travel the wicked world that we've already traveled.
Yes.
But when death comes, it's a time to rejoice, knowing they have fought it back, won it, and now seated at the right hand of God.
Yes.
I hope you follow me now. even the hazards of life are inescapable. We have diseases everywhere.
Yes, yes.
God shall throw diseases upon you that no man can heal.
Praise Him.
Famine all over the land.
Yes.
Earthquakes where they've never been seen before. Tornadoes of all kinds. Storms, and there is even death. We need that fourth member to be with us in our former furnace of life. One of the great promises was that Jesus made to mankind is that I'll never leave you, never forsake you. Whatever you're going through right now, my brothers and sisters, Jesus is with you. This is the truth that we must believe. I heard the Reverend pray this morning. You can pray, but unless you believe, it's all in vain. All the faith that you have in the one that called the Son of God.
Yes.
We must have the help of others. You can't make it by yourself.
Praise
you are not living alone in this world. This is why I warn everybody, try to get connected with the house of God somewhere. I have so many people call me and say, Pastor, I've lost a loved one, but they never belonged to a church in their life. But I'm a light for the land at peace in the house of God. That's fine, but why travel this old wicked world?
Praise
you don't have to connect with somebody that can help you along the way. Right now we live in a world that act like it don't need God and have no fear of God. Every time you turn around, somebody is killing somebody else. Somebody is stealing from somebody. We in trouble. I said we in trouble. The astronaut Bowman said concerning the success of the mission, he said we stood on the shoulders of giants. Of course, he was referring to all the astronauts of the past and of the future. And also, he was talking about the astronauts who had or would give their life in order to make that mission. We know if you kept the history, many have died. Well, we have also been a spiritual giant that had passed this way before. To show us how they got over. But it amazed me, my brothers and sisters, to see how many that call themselves Christians but do not have faith in the fourth man called Jesus. We like to brag about we go to church. But too many go to church Sunday after Sunday for the wrong reason. A lot of us go because we have made the church a fashion show. We have dressed a certain way. I'm so glad my word said, come as you are. I find out that God will dress you up. And have faith in God. But too many come here for a different reason. I don't know about you, but I come to church because somebody said Jesus is a doctor in a sick room. I found out that medicine sometimes cannot heal you. Many have years ago.
Yeah.
Used to be an alcoholic.
Yeah.
Whiskey to anybody in here.
Yeah.
But the Lord, you don't have to be saved in the house of God. But when He saves you, you'll come to the house of God.
Yeah.
I was saved in my sleep. Went to bed drunk like I always drunk. Woke up the next morning like I never had a drink in my life. No alcohol, diamond, no drinking. I had that fourth day of the truth that was in bed with me. Woke me up that morning. Woke me up and started me on my way. I've been preaching ever since. We're calling to preach and save my soul from a friend. We're talking about somebody was praying for me. Somebody was on my side. Somebody was in my. I wasn't in this world by myself. You know what? Sometimes we say the Lord hadn't done no good. Whatever He did in your life, it's more than somebody to somebody else. Let the world know how He brought you over. Let the world know what it did for you. I wish somebody hear me today. The devil don't want you to testify. Because if you find out what He can do, then you know if He did it for Him, He'll do it for you yourself. I wish somebody hear me today. It's something about serving God that there is no faith. And that fourth great part of life should be given heaven up, sir. Need I say more, my brother and sister? But we need the you minister, not so much of our high ministry. We already want to get patted on our own back. On the dog back for you. God will give you the praise later on in glory. But you need to help somebody along the way. Somebody said, if I travel this roll along and help somebody, then my living will not be in vain. Stop trying to be Mr. So-and-so, Miss So-and-so yourself. Be what the Lord has called you to be. Don't try to be like somebody else. Somebody here they call somebody in the choir to sing. You might not sing like you have, but you have a voice. And your voice in God's sight is as good as their voice. Don't try to sing like them. Sing like yourself. Somebody help me today. We live in a society now always trying to be what they're not. God knows who you are. He created you. That's why I'm so glad about Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. It was men that knew who they were. They told that old king, said, I don't know why we're in this conversation. No, I cannot bow down to heaven. I'm not going to serve you, God. But the God that I serve is able to bring me out. But if He don't bring me out, I still will not serve you, God. That's the way we have to treat the world today. Don't let them change you. Oh, whatever you're going through, tell them, I don't know how I got here, but I know the Lord has something to do with it. You got on your own, brothers and sisters.
That
fourth member of that crew, we cannot be overcome without that fourth man in the crew. And old Nephthah is, and he got angry when they refused to follow his command. And they tell me they made the father for a seven times harder than it was before. And he got some of his best men to pick old Shadrach, Meshach, and throw them into the fire. But when they got close to the flame killed old that threw them in there. But the word said old Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego all dressed up in the number one suit, walked in the flame. And did nothing happen to them. They tell me that he woke up, looked around, saw somebody walking around in the forest. He said, did we not throw three in there? They said, yes, commander. He said, but I see four walking, and the fourth look like the Son of God. There's something about that. You must understand. There was the three Hebrew born. Now they refused to serve the God, his God. But sometimes we compromise to work. But somebody is not going our way. We try to take short turns and compromise with God. Go through the storm. Go through the battle. And when you come out on the other side, everything's going to be all right. Somebody might be going through some kind of battle right now. Remember that trouble brings patience. And then if you go through that battle, you have nothing to worry about. Because it's stronger than you were when you win. Trouble come my way. It lets me know that I still have a God. I need to get on my knees. I also know if something happened in my life, I'm like everybody else. I forget about God. Turn my back on God. But God, let trouble come your way. Get on your knees sometimes. They brought the presence of God within the presence of their life. Otherwise, if you had faith in God, you would bring God into your life.
Yes.
What are you going through right now? Believe that the Lord is going to bring out.
Oh,
you have faith in God,
yes,
bring that fourth man presence. Are you following me today? Oh, how we need the presence of that fourth man in our life today. We need him in our school. That's what's wrong with the schools today. There's no faith in the Jesus the Christ there. In our homes now, we don't know anything about the Lord. Even in some churches now, all we know is prosperity gospel. But my word say, he said, if I be lifted up, I'd call him out of the name. In the government right now, we serve the government now, do not know God or fear God. We have killing, we have disease, we have famine, we have earthquake, we have tornadoes, we have storm, but nobody is getting on their knees and praising. That's why God said, my people who are called my name are never set to pray. Seek my face tonight, and then you can turn from our wicked way. He said, then I will hear from heaven. I will forgive the sin and heal the land. We have the power to call healing upon this whole world. This indispensable fourth member of life mission is available to us only through faith in our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. You gotta have faith in the man called you.
Yes.
You gotta have faith that he'll feed you.
Yes.
You gotta have faith that he'll guide you.
Yes.
You gotta have faith that he'll keep you.
Oh.
You gotta have faith. I'm talking about faith.
Yes.
You have faith, you can't please God.
Yes.
I've heard somebody say, Jesus, all the world to me. My life, my joy, my all.
Yes.
He is my strength from day to day. Without him, I would fall. When I'm sad, to him I go. Because no other one can cheer me so. When I'm sad, he makes me glad. For he is my friend. I know about you. What a friend we have in Jesus. When I call on him sometime, because I call on him, I say that the Lord, you are my shepherd. I shall not go. somebody's heart, softened, might be your worst enemy. Come happy.
Yes.
That's the way God works. Don't think God. God can only use your friend.